Christ.
Madume ka lebitso la Jesu.
My name is Pamela, I'm from Witbank.
I'm from Witbank.
I was here December, I gave testimony of an increase at work and also a car.
Ke tle mo ka December ka tla ka fa bopaki ba inkokeletso ko merokong le koloi.
As if that's not enough, people of God, I've been blessed also with the promotion at my work.
Modimba ntshofa tshe ka kokoletso tlatlhosho ko merokong.
But I must say this promotion I struggled over the last 2 years because I had been to 5 interviews and there was no response.
Ke le ka isokolela mengwa e mebedi ya feta ke le ka di interview tse 5 a bona o ke le ka khumana karabo.
It only took one interview, 10 minutes I was done and the job was offered.
Ke le interview ka 10 minutes e be setse go fedile ka khumana moshomo.
And also I've been blessed also with the house.
Modimba tshofa tshe gapele ka ntlo.
And also, most importantly, my life before I joined the church, I was not living a straight life. I have now 4 months without touching alcohol. I'm happy at home, we are happy. I would like to thank the God of Charis. Thank you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. On November, I came here for a testimony that the company that I'm working for has promoted, has given me a management post. Then, after they appointed me for management in November, then they started giving me a very rough rules to give to the employees. Then I tried to question them why they actually want me to abuse authority by mistreating the employees. Then I told them that I cannot do that. If they want the work to be done properly, they rather hire than for me to actually abuse the people that are reporting to me. Then from that day, things started to get very tough from my side. Last week, they called me again. And said, now because you don't want to implement what we are telling you, we are suspending you from service with immediate effect. And then I was given a date for hearing. Then I went to hearing, it was on Friday. Then when I got there, they asked me if I want to start by presenting my story or they should start. Then I asked them to present their story first. Then they said they are finished, now it's my turn. I told them that my story is I'm resigning with immediate effect. Then they didn't want me to go, and then they even locked the gate for some hours. Begging me not to go. But I told them that my time with you is over. So I want to thank God because after I separate myself with them on Friday, I was given an appointment by another bigger company. So, even when I look at the company that I was working, I just see a shake. Because the one that I'm working now is very big company with many benefits. So I would like to thank God for what He has done for my life. Amen.
Okay, before I give my testimony, I'm gonna tell you where it all started. At the beginning of this year, I told myself that I wanted to be a Christian who follows God and obeys every commandment that God has.
ngwaro wa uthoma ke ile ka ipotsa gore ke nyako ba mopholoshwa o shetse modimo morao wa o dira ka makatse modimo ba bolelang.
I stopped becoming a church goer and I started become a Christian who obeys and who is faithful to God.
Ka tlogela go ba motho ya nkerekeng fela ka thomo ba mopholoshwa o tshepalang o theletsa modimo.
I paid my tithe.
Ka ntsha karola lesome.
I did everything that God required me to do.
Ka dira ka makatse modimo ba boletseng gore ke swentse ke di diye.
And I saw God working in my life.
Ka bona modimo ba bereka bophelong baka.
2 weeks back, I bought the prophetic calendar.
Bekeche pedi tsa ofeta ke le ka reka calendar ya profeto.
I found my family members, one of the of whom I knew was HIV positive.
Ka phone le ba leloko la ka o mo beketse ba gore o na o HIV positive.
I told them about the prophetic calendar and what they want me to write so that what they want God to do for them.
Ka ba botsa ka prophetic calendar ka ba botsa gore ba nyaka gore ke bangwalele eng mo go yona.
She didn't tell me that she wanted God to heal her.
A senge ba mpotsa gore ba nyaka modimo ba fodisha.
And I think it's because she had accepted her condition.
Ke nano ka ba ka ba pese tshe ba amogetse siemo sa bona.
But I wrote it down. I said, God, on this day, I want you to heal this person in Jesus' name.
Kangwala fasekara morena ka chachile le jeng ke gopela le fodishe motho.
Last week Sunday, Apostle said, if you know there's someone who's sick at home, come to the fort so that I can pray for them.
Beke o feta ka sonta di barele ifo tsewa gona le motho lo lang ko gae etla mo pele ke gone go rapelela.
Okay. And then I wrote on the prophetic calendar that I wanted God to heal this person, even though they didn't mention it.
Kangwala mo prophetic calendar re ke gopela modimo ba fodishe motho le ba senke ba bolele.
So on Sunday when Apostle called us to the fourth and he prayed for me, I could feel God touching me and I knew that she was healed.
Ka sontae de di ba re bitsa o torapela mo pele ke kule modimo mo gare ga ka katse bo re modimo ba mo fodishitse.
And then when I left here, I called her and I told her that God has healed you. Go and get tested. You are no longer sick.
Ka re ke tshoma kereke ka ba phone la ka ba botsa gore modimo ba fodishitse aba e bo testa aba salwala.
She just said, oh, Lidoya.
Vanoro, okay, I'll go.
And then it was Monday. Apostle had declared 3 days. So it was Monday, I called and said, have you gone there?
And then Daddy Baileba, Polelo Robar Fama Chacha Mararo Kasunta, Kam Supuluka, Bafonela, Kiba Wich Shore, Bailina.
She didn't go. And on Wednesday, when I was coming to church, I called her. I said, you are delaying me. I need to give a testimony. Did you go there?
Aska komolola senke bae ka labora roka ba phone la ke kitla mo kerekeng ka botsa gore le ya nditela ke nya ko fa bupaki le ile na.
She said no.
Are awwa.
I just thought to myself, I know that God has healed her. She just doesn't believe or she has accepted or she, I don't know, but it's fine. I know God has healed her. So I put that on the side.
Kano ipocho riki ya tsebore modimo ba ba fodishitse le e bantse ba santsepe.
Yesterday when I called her,
mabana ke ba founela.
She said to me, I just got back from the doctor.
Armon now bachwa ko docteng.
And I am healed.
Ene ke fodile. Amen.
Jesus. The past 2 weeks, I was given an opportunity to see the men of God one-on-one. And he gave me two prophetic words. Okay, one of them has already come to pass. It was that I mustn't worry about my contract, which is ending at my previous job.
Because
God is going to bless me with a very good job.
And indeed
it has happened. God has blessed me with a permanent good job. So I thank God so much.
Hallelujah. Greetings in the name of Jesus. My testimony regards on Sunday, did he declare that he's giving us 3 days?
And then Wednesday, late nyana, ndamo diwana kolo ya mshumu wa permanent, but then sign a contract in Labuna.
On Wednesday late, I got a phone call that I should come and sign the contract on Thursday for a permanent job.
I will be lindi ubacha declare ukubana free education, ukubana problem, oka kama tu denela awo jenanga 2017.
Since it has been declared that there will be free education, all the students from 2017 had a problem of the fees which were being given to the new students of 2018.
So ndi kolibwa mudzimu ngori namusi ndi chikwamba nga machelone ndo wana message yo confirm uri nene vusasi yo badela then zvambori ndi kwadza chikolone omwana.
I thank God that God has blessed me with a bursary of NEFSAS and I'm going back to school. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let me greet you in the name of our Lord Christ Jesus. Amen.
Madimekele bitso la Jesu.
In November 2017, I had one-on-one meeting with Daddy.
God, November 2017, kileka abamu yengeli Daddy.
Daddy gave me 2 prophecies, which really surprised me.
Daddy bampari prophecy pedi chaji makadi cheng.
The first prophecy, Daddy said to me, "I see you flying as a consultant and making money."
Prophet osamatoma Daddy barababa na ki flyer ki na meche aeroplane as a consultant ki dia chalete.
I didn't understand that because I'm full-time employed and I'm happy where I'm working.
Kasiki kushishika oreke bereka na kukamoka endiki tabili kama shuma waka.
Daddy said to me, "Don't worry, someone is going to approach you."
Barakiska bilela motomu ototla mokunna.
During the second week of December, indeed, a multi-millionaire American approached me.
Ka dispegeje peria December omu wobal di chelete wako America atla mokunna.
And requested me to do a consultancy job for him in the Eastern Cape.
Ang kopala ko rekid yung consultant meron ko wao consulta ko Eastern Cape.
And my company where I'm working approved that, and I've already started doing that.
Mo kibera kang ko na ba tumela na len na sa chiki tumilo kibera ka kamo.
The second prophecy, which really surprised me, they did declare promotion where I'm working.
Se profeto sabo bedi deti ba ile bampuja ka promotion mo kibera kang ko na.
I couldn't understand that because the position I was occupying then was the highest possible in that company.
Begisa kushika re siemo se ke berekang go sona ko company ke se se golo go tsona jotlhe ka moka.
But on Thursday last week, the CEO
Kalabone beke go feta.
The CEO of the company called me to a meeting.
CEO monga company am picha gore re ye meeting
and confirmed that I've been promoted to the very senior management position. The position which was never there, it was created for me. And in that position, I will be responsible for employment relations. In a group of 8 companies.
Who the company J8.
And it started with effect from 1st February
2018.
Children of God and viewers at home, let me advise you. The first advice is that all these blessings have got nothing to do with my personal abilities. They've got nothing to do with my qualifications or experience. But it's because of the grace from this house. And the favor upon my life. The second advice to you children of God and the viewers at home is that when a true prophet of God, like Apostle Jeremiah Kananisa of Tembisa,
of Charis Missionary Church in
Tembisa. Wa Charis Missionary Church ya ko Winnie Mandela Zone 5 Tembisa.
When he prophesies you.
Ga boledishana le bophelo ba gao.
When he gives you a word.
Ga o falentshi.
What you need to do.
So o tshwanetseng go se dira.
Just believe.
Dumela fela. Amen.
Just believe and hold on to that word.
Dumela fela o sware lentshi leo.
And it shall come to pass.
And it will diragala.
And I thank God for that.
Ke leboga modimo ka seo.